A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 29th May, on the front page you have Karnataka ordered to release 9.19 TMC feet. That is, Kaveri Water Management Authority has ruled on this and water has to be released by Karnataka for Tamil Nadu for the month of June 2019. So this is the ruling you can see. So it will be released from the Viligudiya reservoir to the Metro Dam in Tamil Nadu. Below you have scientists give thumbs up for Anthropocene epoch. So on May 21, a 34-member panel of Anthropocene Working Group voted 29-4 in favor of designating a new geological epoch, the Anthropocene. So Anthro is related to humans. So means the idea is that the Holocene epoch. So it is geological eras and epochs which we discussed the time as it has elapsed. So Holocene epoch began around 11,700 years ago, and it is said now the Holocene epoch ends and Anthropocene epoch commences. So a formal proposal, you know, will also be given for the new epoch by 2021 to the International Commission on Stratigraphy, which oversees the official geological time chart. So this is there, and it is said that this new epoch reflects how Earth has been shaped by human activity. You know, how there's pollution taking place and environment changing, you know, concrete, fly ash, plastics, etc. Techno fossils, as they are said, produced from these and other materials which are affecting the environment. You can see the term Anthropocene was coined in 2000 by Nobel laureate Paul Crutzen and Eugene Stürmer to denote the present geological time interval in which human activity has profoundly altered many conditions and processes on Earth. On page 9, you have post Balakot, Indian Air Force zeroes in on key vulnerabilities. So, drawing lessons from the Balakot airstrike, Indian Air Force has identified a shortage of airborne warning and early warning system. So, airborne warning and control system, AWACS aircraft, should be there to provide round-the-clock surveillance, and this was a major deficiency which the IF Indian Air Force faced. So what we saw in February 2019, the airstrike and aerial engagement, you know, with Pakistan Air Force. So this has been reviewed now and lessons learned from it. So it says if we had the technological advantage, we could have imposed costs on the adversary. So resource optimization is being proposed now. Soon the Rafale fighters would also be there for Indian Air Force available. So you can see this is Netra Airborne Early Warning and Control System. It says that Pakistan currently has an advantage as they have more AWACS airborne warning. They have 7 AWACS and could keep one on our side at all times. In contrast, Indian Air Force operates 3 Israeli Falcon AWACS and 2 indigenous Netra AWACS. So, the Netra has been indigenously built by DRDO. So, we have 3 plus 2, 5, while Pakistan has 7. So, it could deploy one over India. So, we are going to have 3 more Netra systems, you know, from DRDO. So, that is, there are also 2 more Falcon AWACS from Israel, you know, will be procured. On the editorial page, the first editorial is to be decisive. So this is regarding how Prime Minister Modi must deepen his message of carrying everyone's trust. So what he says, sabka saath, sabka vikas, sabka vishwas, he has to deepen his message. So make it meaningful. And then this is pending divorce. So this is regarding Brexit. So it says the leadership struggle among Britain's ruling Tories may make Brexit more chaotic. So this, we have seen how British Prime Minister Theresa May is going to step down on 7th June and a new leader would be coming up. So this is in the context that Brexit deal, which she clinched with European Union, was not acceptable in Britain. So now, you know, the new leader would be coming forth. So it says this leadership struggle, and from the same political party, the Conservative Party. So this struggle as such is saying that will make Brexit more chaotic. The lead article, the key agenda must be to accelerate growth. So it says only a fast growing economy can generate surpluses needed to create jobs and sustain social safety nets. So economy should be boosted, and that should be the primary focus of the government, is what this article says. And this is another opportunity missed. So it says Congress needs regional allies more than they need it to arrest its complete obsolescence. So Congress is becoming obsolete. So it needs to engage with regional allies. Again, this is political, so you can just skip it. On the op-ed page, then you have coverage on elections. So you can skip this too. On page 13, you have NDA inches towards majority in Rajya Sabha. So it's likely to reach the magic figure of 124 seats in Rajya Sabha out of 250. So this will be possible by 2021 end. So this will depend on the outcome in assembly elections too. So it's states who send their representatives in Rajya Sabha. So it's indirect elections in Rajya Sabha. So this is how the BJP has acquired seats, and how it is expected that BJP will cross this number of 124 seats and get a majority in upper house too. So it's 245 seats presently, the present strength of Rajya Sabha. So 123 is the magic number, and it may come to 124 seats is what this article says. And below you have election commission teams to appraise poll operations. So 8 working groups to review specific areas, including action of on model code of conduct violations, etc., would be formed. So election commission team will appraise the poll operations. On international page, you have Malaysia to send back 450 tons of plastic waste. So minister urges developed nations to stop shipping garbage to developing countries. And here you can see Malaysia said that it will be sending back this plastic waste back to the countries from where it has come. So China had also previously taken a large amount of waste for recycling, but abruptly stopped, saying it wanted to improve its own environment. So such conditions are coming forth now. So plastic imports to Malaysia have actually tripled since 2016. So there are around 450 tons of contaminated plastic waste in 10 containers. So they have come from various countries like Australia, Canada, China, Japan, Saudi, USA, and they will be shipped back is what Malaysia says. Earlier, we have seen how Philippines had threatened that the plastic waste which came to its country from Canada has to be taken back. Otherwise, it will dump that waste in Canada's territorial waters. And this is Sri Lanka, Japan and India signed deal to develop container terminals. So India's role in this project has become a flashpoint in 2018. So an agreement has been reached jointly between them to develop East Container Terminal at Colombo Port. So it's estimated to cost around $500 to $700 million. So this will be a container terminal here. You can see the Sri Lankan Ports Authority retains 100% ownership of the container, while the terminal operations company is jointly owned by the three entities. And in that also, Sri Lanka will hold a 51% stake, and the other two will have a joint venture with 49% stake. Then here you have German government asks people to wear kippah. So this kippah controversy which took place in Germany, now the German government, when a German minister said that he cannot recommend people to wear kippah all the time. So the Israeli president also raised concerns on such remarks. And now the German government has called on people to wear the Jewish kippah ahead of anti-Israel protests as a demonstration of solidarity, and as Jews face a spike in anti-Semitism. Then on business page also, here you have trouble brews for coffee growers. So spotty rains will impact the bean output. So summer showers will drastically pull down the coffee beans production this year. So it will be almost half of normal year's yield according to Coffee Board of India and the planters. So this is the domestic coffee industry been affected for the second consecutive coffee year, and growers are yet to recover from last year's devastating floods that washed away some plantations entirely in Kerala and Karnataka. So here you can see this is again spotty rain affecting the crop. Then there's no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.